As we promised, today we are going to tell you about setting grading tool that is manual grading. So wait for a little longer and watch our intro if you are new to our channel. Hello guys, welcome back to Attiration. Myself Muskan, and here on this channel we teach you about 3D design software and many fashion related topics. So stay tuned and keep watching. Today I have opened my dress one about which we teach you earlier. You can watch it from above link if you want to see its tutorial. So we are going to start the grading without wasting any time. So we have to resize 2D window so that we will be able to see our tool. Auto grading is already discussed, so you can watch it from above link if you haven't watched it till now. After this, select the tool called grading from here, and from your object browser open grading column where all your grading will be seen. Currently it's completely blank because we haven't done any grading yet, but you can see add or assign are here. Now we will see in how many ways we can grade our pattern. So firstly, select that plus sign. We get a first grading. Now after this, select one plus sign which is visible now. It will help you to create different sizes from single size, or should I say base pattern. Suppose size 1 is our base pattern, so we will rename it accordingly. I am leaving small as a base, which means all your pattern will be graded according to this size. So rest of the pattern will be medium, large and extra large. Currently the size we have mentioned doesn't have any pattern allotted. So you have to select your whole pattern and select this assign to selected pattern option. After that, this pattern can be graded. You can even take any size as your base pattern just by ticking over it. You can even separate the grading for each pattern. So if you want to separate your sleeve from rest of the pattern, then you can do that as well. Just select add, and after that select your sleeve or the pattern that you want to grade separately and press on assign to selected pattern option. After that, your sleeve will be separated from the rest of the pattern. Now if I will select this sleeve, then size group 2 will be highlighted. And if I will select my another part of the sleeve that is in another group, that will be highlighted. But currently we don't want that, so we will delete that group. Our labeling is done. Now we have to actually grade each pattern. It might be possible that you won't be able to see anything in Property Editor. It's because of no pattern is selected. So select any pattern point from your window. Zoom in a bit so that we can see the pattern properly. Here, first option is distance, where X and Y value will be mentioned. Let's see how these values should be input. If you want to shift your pattern upward or downward, then you have to change Y value accordingly. Add minus if you want to move in downward direction, and if you want to move right, then you have to change X value and add minus in value to move it toward left. We will write 0.5 in medium and 1 in large and 1.5 in extra large because we want it to move toward right. This size is increasing accordingly. Suppose our each size is increasing at an interval of 0.5 inch. So we have to increase the size of the pattern with that value. Similarly, if we have extra small in place of extra large, then what will be the case? So to show you, let me change it into extra small. Now we have an option to degrade our pattern. So what should be the value of X axis? Now we have to move it in left direction. That's why we will put minus with the 0.5. By this way our pattern will go inside instead of going outside. Let me do the same with the below points. Write these same value 0.5, 1 and minus 0.5. Now, if you want to move your pattern upward or downward, change your value by keeping that in the mind. So, I want to move this pattern downward, then I will put minus with my value. So, minus 0.5, minus 1 and plus 0.5, since we need it to move in upward direction. Now, I am going to select other side of this pattern, but this time I am going to use offset instead of distance. So, let's see how this works. For deciding the value in offset, we have to set a standard. As in other side, we shifted our pattern by 0.5 in both x and y axis. Here, we want to shift it in left, so write minus 0.5 in x axis, and for downward direction, we will put minus 0.5 inches in y axis. But if you guys have noticed, our last pattern piece grading is wrong, since our pattern is converted from large to extra small. So we have to write the value accordingly. We will see how to change the value by both options. In offset, we will write 1.5 because we want this pattern to move in right direction from large to extra small. So 0.5, 0.5 and 0.5 is 1.5. After this, we will try to change y-axis value available in distance. Here, we will only write 0.5 because we want to move it in upward direction, and also because we are shifting our pattern from small to extra small only. So the value will be different every time. You need to do some calculation, and after that everything will be ready. We will do the same thing with the above point but according to its movement. Now, we will show you how you can grade your pattern just by using your arrow key. So, the instruction is available on your screen. The instruction is simple. Shift the point according to the arrow. Now, we have to select the pattern that we want to grade. Here, we can even decide how much we want to grade by the help of the arrow. You can see at the bottom it's written arrow key movements. So you can change this value however you like. I am setting it at 1. So now our pattern will grade according to this value. Select your pattern and use your arrow. Want to move it in right? So press right arrow key. All the hassle is solved and you can simply grade your pattern just by using arrow. Now we will tell you how you can grade your pattern even by selecting a line. So select the line of this side and use arrow key to move it. We have to move this pattern in left direction, that's why we will press left arrow key. If you want to grade your pattern by writing the value but want to keep it simple, then you can select the line and change the value after that. Do you know that you can even copy paste your grading? So now we will grade this side of our sleeve, and after this right click over it to copy and paste to the side where you want the grading. So now we have discussed all the way by which you can do the grading. The value I am using for grading isn't the only one to put in, but you can write the value in the way your pattern is increasing. After grading, your pattern piece of all size will be ready. And now after selecting the size, you can see the change in your size as well. Like we have medium activated now. Let me simulate the new size for you. You can see the fitting of medium size on our avatar. You can even hide your grading line if they are disturbing you when you are not working on it from 2D Windows side option. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you are as passionate about fashion as I am, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more unique and exciting classes coming your way. I can't wait to share my experience with you and inspire you to express yourself through fashion. See you in next video. Bye.